Okay. All right, giving everyone a chance to log in. Hi, hi, big ups. I see Andy. Hi, Andy. So excited to create with everyone. So anyone that is logged in, we are creating a mixed media whale today. So he'll be hanging on the side for reference. A lot of people were asking, what do I need to create this whale today? And just like every week, guys, whatever you have works. So I'll be using a canvas and acrylic paint. I'll be using a straight edge tool. I use a random ruler to scrape some different colors on and have fun with. So anything that has a straight edge can be used. You can also just kind of use your paintbrush to have fun with adding different textures and colors. So really any tools that you have, if you just have a sketch pad, colored pencils, a pencil that you want to use to sketch it out, it's really just about you guys kind of creating the space and time to create and some self-care and some community and creativity. So that's always my main goal. So whatever you have will be just fine. So I'll give everyone a minute to log in. Also, everyone get a chance to set up all their tools and materials. I have our little whale hanging on the wall that we'll be painting alongside my blank canvas. I'll wait like another 2 more minutes for anyone that might be joining in. Thank you as always for joining. I know time is super valuable, so I always appreciate to see all these smiling faces. And the first thing you can think of, anyone that is here and all set up and ready, think about a background color that you might want to use for your whale. So for me, I did like a brighter teal for my background on this one. So we're just gonna do one full color for our background first, and then we're gonna add some textures and layers. Today for this one, I'm gonna go a little lighter just to make sure that my color and my outline shows up for you guys. So I'm doing like a really light aqua, but any color you wanna use, obviously the blues feel great, the blues and greens for the ocean, but really it's your whale. So make it whatever you want. You can do a rainbow background, some pinks and cotton candy colors. So that's a good way to get started. I'll check our waiting room, make sure I don't have any more.
Open your stuff so I can ask you these simple things. Do you love the ocean? Could you love the ocean with me?
I'll be playing a lot of ocean-minded music today because that inspired me for the whale. This is Ziggy Alberts. He's amazing when it comes to an ocean vibe. It's called Follow the Ocean.
These are the simple things I want you, cause these are the simple things.
All right, so I think anyone that jumps in from here on, they can just jump right in. Before we get started in our session, I'm gonna turn down the music just a little bit. I have 2 quotes I wanna share, and then just a little text about whales to kind of get us started and set our intention. I always feel like it's super important before creating to set a little intention. Maybe this time that you have with your family, a time that you put aside for yourself, for self-care, just an hour is sometimes so hard to find in the week. So what is your intention today? Why did you show up today? It doesn't have to be the same as mine. I just kind of want to share where I started. So I love the ocean. Surfing deepened my love for the ocean and just connecting with it in a way that feels so pure. There's this one quote from Thich Nhat Hanh that I actually have like on my desk. I framed it. I took it out of one of his books and it means so much to me. And it's called Touching the Earth. And this could look different for everybody. So in whatever way you touch the earth, just going for a walk, going to the ocean, hiking, riding a bike, going for a run. So whatever that means to you, that's kind of where it starts. And it says, in the Buddhist tradition I am part of, we do a practice called touching the earth every single day. It helps us in many ways. You too could be helped by doing this practice. When you feel restless, lack of confidence in yourself, or when you feel angry or unhappy, you can kneel down and touch the ground deeply with your hands. Touch the earth as if it were your favorite thing to do or your best friend. The earth has been there for a long time. She is mother to all of us. She knows everything. The Buddha asked the earth to be his witness by touching her with his hands when he had some doubt and fear before his awakening. The earth appeared to him as a beautiful mother. In her arms, she carried flowers and fruit, birds and butterflies, and many different animals and offered them to the Buddha. The Buddha's doubts and fears instantly disappeared. Whenever you feel unhappy, come to the earth and ask her for help. Touch her deeply, the way Buddha did. Suddenly, you too will see the earth with all her flowers and fruit trees and birds and animals and all living beings that she has produced. All these things she offers to you. You have more opportunities to be happy than you ever thought. The earth shows her love to you and her patience. The earth is very patient. She sees you suffer. She helps you and she protects you. When we die, she takes us back into her arms. With the earth, you are very safe. She is always there in all her wonderful expressions, like the trees, flowers, butterflies, and sunshine. Whenever you are tired or unhappy, touching the earth is a very good practice to heal you and restore your joy. So that's one of my favorite quotes. And just a reminder that no matter what's going on in our lives, what we're going through, any suffering, there's so much beauty around us. And I feel like Mother Nature gives us such a great glimpse into that. And it's just a constant reminder. So when I'm out in the ocean and I see a dolphin or I share a special moment with someone I love, that's something that kind of wakes me back up and brings me back to the present moment. And that's kind of where this whale came from, was just that joy I feel from the ocean and Mother Nature. So I hope to share that with you today. I also want to set an intention of trusting our inner voice. So a lot of times whales are connected to trusting your inner voice and a lot of deep wisdom from within. So that today was another intention I had for all of us, is just to kind of trust yourself and know yourself and trust that you can do anything that life throws your way and to find your path and follow it no matter what. And this is from Young Pueblo. This is another great book I have, Clarity and Connection. And they're just great little quotes that you can open to any day. And it says, when in doubt, remember you have the power to say no, the authenticity to be you, the patience to keep learning, the fortitude to continue trying, the courage to embrace change, the fearlessness to give selflessly, the wisdom to cultivate inner peace, the bravery to fulfill your aspirations, the openness that grows friendships, awareness to follow your intuition, and the intelligence to not repeat the past. So we have all of those things within us. We don't need to look outward for any of that. So just a reminder and an intention for that today as well. Without further ado, we'll get started. First thing we're going to do is just paint our backgrounds, whatever color we want. So I'm going to paint my canvas with a little blue aqua. I'm going to cover the whole thing. If you're feeling drawn to do something else for your background, please do it. I'm only here to offer the space and time. So don't feel like you ever have to go exactly with what I do. Oops, someone just joined in. For anyone just joining in, we're just getting started. We are just painting our backgrounds, whatever color we want. I am using acrylic and canvas. Feel free to use any materials that you have, sketch pad, pencil, paper, crowns. Maybe you're working on an already started work of art that you're just here to share the space and create the time for yourself. I always add a little bit of water to my acrylic to help spread it out. And also for backgrounds or water themed paintings, it just gives more of a water feel to it. And I'm just gonna go up and down. So no rhyme or reason what direction you need to go.
See you, thank you. Touch it all around my arms. Take your body. Touch it all around my arms.
And some parts may be a little heavier with color than others. I kind of enjoy that. I try not to get like this perfect solid base. I like the kind of difference in the color and the pops and the texture from it. Definitely not searching for perfection because we're going to be adding a lot of fun layers on top.
Well, I had a dream. I stood beneath an orange sky. Yes, I had a dream. I stood beneath an orange sky.
So I have my base. I'm going to give you guys a couple minutes to get your base color completed.
With my brother Sam. With my sister standing.
I'm also going to read one more thing, just a little blurb about whales while you guys are finishing your backgrounds. So the whale spirit animal is the earth's record keeper for all time. Whales teach you about listening to your inner voice, understanding the impact of your emotions and what they have on your everyday life, and following your own truth. So the whales are commonly associated with emotions, inner truth, and creativity. That's kind of like the spirit animal belief behind a whale. And I always connect so much to that. And if anyone's ever seen a whale in the wild, I've been able to once or twice. Once was in Ocean City when me and Meg and Liz were painting a mural for Bungalow Bowls, and we were on the boardwalk and we looked out and it was fully breaching in the water. It was one of the coolest things ever. And I remember running up and down the boardwalk screaming like, there's a whale! And we've seen one or two on the Cape May Lewis Ferry, which has been really super cool too, like seeing them up close. There's something about being in the presence of something so massive and so beautiful that really takes your breath away. So I think you're reminded of that. And I love kind of what the spirit animal, the whale, represents. Whales are always very special to me. I think they're super majestic. And I always feel that when I create them. So I try and remind myself kind of about moments with them, or read a little bit about them, or watch a little, you know, video about them before I paint them, just so I can kind of connect to that again.
Oh. I've thrown off the weight of this crazy stone. When I've lost all care for the things I own.
Our next step is going to be just adding some texture on top of our backgrounds. And the cool thing about the next step is that our background doesn't have to be dry. It's just kind of a work in progress. And like I said, it's not perfection. It's kind of just cool to see where everything lands. I couldn't create this background again if I tried, because everything's just about going with the flow. Some colors I'm probably going to use are like a darker blue and then probably some white. This is a very similar technique as what we did our last virtual paint jam, where we had a white background and we just kind of scraped some colors on. So we're going to do the same scraping technique, but this time we already have color in the background. So it's going to be like that second layer that we're going to add to. If you don't want to do this and don't feel drawn to do this, please don't. Find a fun way to maybe add a couple color layers to your backgrounds, continue playing around with your color. Maybe you draw a couple bubbles like you're in the ocean. So like I said, don't feel like you have to do this, but it has become a really fun space to play for me. A lot of time my work is very fine line outlines and worrying about having everything so perfect and clean. And this in the past month has been an exploration of more just play with it. So that's kind of why I like sharing it with you guys, to offer that play. So I'm going to go with like a desert turquoise will be the first one. And how I normally do it is just add a couple drops at different places on my canvas. And then I'll just kind of scrape it with a ruler. I'll show you guys. I'm just adding a couple little drops. And a little bit goes a really long way in this, so don't feel like you have to put a lot of paint on. Just the tiniest little drop goes a long way. And then I take my ruler from the top, and I'm just going to gently scrape and see where the paint falls as I go down. Go different ways with it to kind of pull it to the side. Start with a little bit and then you can always add more. So I'm going to add a little bit more of the deeper turquoise, and then I'm probably going to add definitely some white, because I love the contrast of white on top of the colors. It really, really pops off. There is no high, no low, there is nowhere else to go.
except inside your heart and be just who you are.
I may do one other blue to kind of mix a couple different blues together. That's always fun.
To the place where I belong. Watch your mama coming home. To the place where I belong. Watch your mama.
So if you do two colors at once, it's kind of cool how they play off each other.
Nothing, emptiness, you love me, pain, loneliness, the Lord, I'm not afraid no more.
Do one more layer.
Must be something in between the lovely scenes under these trees beneath the sun. I see the people come, the people go, from familiar close, the days and name and fall. Say after all, see what's up for one.
So I'm feeling pretty good about my blues. My next step will probably be to add some white. If you guys have any questions along the way, feel free to type them into the chat. And also, this is the Beautiful Girls. We love them. Marshall and me love them. And this is called Beautiful World. It's a great song. The whole album, I think it's Seaside. I forget what it's called.
Seaside Heights,
whatever that. I'll have this whole playlist up and I'll share it with you guys. It's already on Spotify if you follow us on Spotify, but I'll share it in the follow-up email. But this whole album is amazing. I have a couple from the album on our playlist today. So I'm gonna add some white blobs. I said I love the white, so I usually like to add them pretty thick.
Seaside Highlight Greatest Hits.
That's it. And they're called the Beautiful Girls. White moves quick.
Scrape.
best humorous when the sunlight fills the scrubby empty sheets and days and summer with all of your cheeks. And everything we need, love, I can feel in my bones.
Probably do one more round of white because I love the white. And the next step kind of goes along with this step. Again, not one you should feel like you have to do, but if you're drawn to, give it a try. In this initial painting, I'll kind of hold it up a little closer. You're gonna see like all these little dots and some fun little designs. I actually played around on this one with a little bit of spray paint. So I actually had the stencils and did a little spray paint, which is super fun, but we're not gonna do that today in an enclosed space. But you can achieve that with just kind of adding some designs of your own. So I'm gonna add a couple little bubbles, maybe a couple little lines with my paintbrush that are a little cleaner than the swipe technique. It just gives another layer of mixed media. Again, it's another way to just play before we add the line work on top. Feel free to try it. If you don't want to, don't feel like you have to, but I'll just give a couple minutes for you guys to kind of play around with that. Little trick with trying to get some circles if you feel nervous to draw them, and I never draw a perfect circle. The back of your paintbrush gives a really good circle, and different paintbrushes have different sizes. So you can always dip just the back side of your paintbrush into the paint and give yourself a couple circles or added details, or if you're adding an eye that you're nervous about and want to give a little dot, the back of your paintbrush always works really well. And you can always add more of this after you're done your whale too, if you feel like you want to fill more space. I may add some bubbles with a darker color since I have definitely a softer palette on this one.
Yes, we are blessed to be together on this beautiful, magical day.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll probably stop there for now. Maybe add more later. We will give our, after we kind of achieve the background we want, we will take a few minutes to let it dry before we start sketching our line work. I'll give you guys a couple more minutes.
Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. Let your home, let your sun.
Fun to play around and maybe finger paint a little bit with your little designs.
Direction of the girls, direction of love. Breathe, breathe in the air. Cherish this moment, cherish this moment. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. How you feeling? When you're old and you're sun.
When you feel like falling out on you, like it in you. When you feel this great desire, that it's all safe. Take a stroll through the nearest forest and remember your face. Many moons have risen for the long, long before the day. Some things will know, a touch of my soul. But does your heart say, 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 what does your heart say, does your heart say, what does your heart say, what does your heart say?
While you guys are kind of finishing up your background touches and having fun with bringing that mixed media feeling to life, I'm just going to be pencil sketching the lines of the whale, which I will then be outlining in black marker so you guys can see it well on the screen. I would recommend definitely with your canvas to first pencil sketch. So if you mess anything up, it can erase off and you can kind of make it go away before we add. You can use Sharpie marker, any paint marker. You can use just regular black paint with a thin paintbrush. However you want to achieve that line. And we'll be using some black and then a little bit of white paint to kind of add in the belly region of the whale. But I'll just give it a quick little sketch on top of the canvas while you guys finish up your backgrounds. And then we'll kind of jump into the line work.
So follow, follow the sun, which way the moon goes, this day is gone. Thank you.
lying, not you anymore. It's waiting in your own backyard. You can make the flame meet the killing, make the fire. Anybody sees the heart. It's funny how I'm blind to dreams of you. Seems like we love up too far.
All right.
It's good to be right here.
Does anyone have any questions so far? How's everyone doing? If anyone wants to share their backgrounds, they can hold them up if they'd like. You can just give a thumbs up if you want. I love it. I see Indy's background looks beautiful. Emily, awesome. Big ups, you guys.
You can beat the moonlight, you're not your real one.
So I do have one other thing I'm going to share. It's probably good that we share it now because we're letting our backgrounds dry just a little bit more. I'm gonna do a screen share, which I did last time, and then I always get nervous that it's not gonna work right, so bear with me. It's just a little minute blurb from a documentary film about actual orca whales. I love orcas, they're probably my favorite whale. And it's just a scientist kind of talking about how magical they are and how the First Nations people viewed whales and just how special they are. So it's really, really quick, but I just feel like with the music and him talking, it almost brings me to tears every time I watch it. So I screen recorded it this morning just so I can share it with you guys. So I'm gonna give it a shot, just bear with me while I get it on the screen. And if you wanna turn your sound up so you can hear it, it's just like a minute long, like I said, so I'm gonna jump on and share that now so we can kind of have time for our backgrounds to dry. So you guys should be on my screen. There is some closed captioning in another language, so I apologize for that, but this is the only way I could record it. So here we go. Oh, hold on one sec. I think it turned the volume down. Give me one sec. It should come on now. Here we go.
The First Nations people and the old fishermen on the coast, they call them blackfish. And they're an animal that possesses great spiritual power and they're not to be meddled with. I've spent a lot of time around killer whales and they're always in charge. I never get out of the boat. I never mess with them. The speed and the power is quite amazing. Rules are the same as pool hall. Keep 1 foot on the floor at all times. Even after seeing them thousands of times, you see him and you still, you know, wake up.
All right. So now I'm going to go back to you guys, stop share. Okay. So that should have came through for you guys. Okay. Should let me come back on. All right. So that's just from a little documentary film, just when he talks about what a force they are and how they were viewed as just never to be meddled with, never to be messed with. They're to be honored and respected. And I love how he puts that. And that's why it's so special to always draw and create them. So now we're going to start our line work. I will try and do this step by step. Sometimes it can be a little confusing because of how it's all connected. And kind of the idea of this is that it's almost one stroke that takes you all the way through. But we're not going to do that. We're going to break it down step by step so we can all kind of take our time and flow with it. So first thing you want to do is we're going to start kind of in the middle of our drawing, however you want to hold it. And pretty far over to whatever end the nose is going to be on your piece. So he could be flipped, he could be facing either way. But for me, I'm going to start over here. So I'm going to just draw a little dot where you guys can kind of see where I'm starting. So this is my start point right here. And I'm going to curve around and come down to a point down here. Okay, so the first line is just one swoop to the bottom. Okay, so that's it. I'm going to thicken it up a little bit so you guys can see it better. So I'll go over it a couple times. Like I said, starting in pencil always makes it a little less stressful in case you want to move your lines around a little bit. You can erase them off the canvas. And I am using paint markers. That's often what I use on my canvas for line work. These are Craft Smart. You can find them at Michael's. I always find myself coming back to these ones. I really do like them. They aren't oil-based markers, so it's not water-based, so it's a little more pigmented, has like a high gloss shine. But they're kind of my favorite on canvas, especially. Marshall's giving Leah a massage, our little dog. With his roller. She is a mess. Next, we're just gonna, so this is actually the fin of the whale. And we're just gonna bring it up and do a little swirl. So just like a little loop. All right, so we have kind of the tip of the nose coming down to that first chin.
I'm not sure.
God bless you.
God bless you. Because I'm not sure.
I'm going to continue this line all the way up to the top, and it's actually going to start his tail. Vocals from Marshall are free in the background.
This song is popular for the most best surf session ever in Stradbury. You can find it on East Wood.
This is a song Marshall used for an edit for a surf session we shared like 2 years ago in Strathmere that we all still talk about. One of those magical sessions with Mother Nature. And like I said, this is Ziggy Alberts. We love him.
Thank you.
Wish you could see our crazy dog right now.
This day is getting older. Fading light. It's beautiful.
So now I'm going to make one swoop for one side of the tail and then come over to the other side of the tail. And I'm stopping the line work pretty much up at the top. So it's going to stop up there. So we will continue and complete the whole tail next. So it's just one, I kind of curve in a little bit and then round it to give a little bit of a tail feel. And then do the same on the other side. And then just bring it in and down and stop kind of like right there. I'll kind of thicken it up so you guys can see it a little better. I normally do like a couple little dots at the end just for fun.
But your role is yours to tread. That's so it goes. That's so it goes. That's so it goes. So it's your mind.
So we got our tail.
That's so it goes.
Try and move this in a little bit so you guys can see a little closer. That might help. There we go. She's eating a piece of paper.
This life be true. I got some advice for you. Don't bow your head to no one, and no matter what you do, if you start something, see it through. So sturdy up your heart. Let me tell you something, because your road is long ahead. Hey, Andy. I'ma be with you no matter where you are. But let me tell you something about your life. It's your road and you gotta tread it. So it goes. And so it goes. And so it goes. Slows your mind. So it goes.
Big ups to Marshall. Cameo.
One of my favorite songs.
This is called Lamar by the Beautiful Girls.
One of my favorite songs.
Great song.
Great song.
We have a couple versions of it too that are really good. Oh, this is Ziggy Marley. True to myself. Gotta be true to yourself. So now we're gonna finish the belly side of the whale. So I'm gonna kind of curve where we started. I'm gonna go back to and do a little squiggle line to bring us down to the bottom, almost halfway through his fin over here, okay? So I'm gonna show you. So I kind of round it, do a little squiggle, and come down. I'm gonna stop right there so you guys can get that far. Just for perspective, like this is where we're going to be putting his eye. So that's kind of why I curved that out a little bit. We're going to put one eye there so you can kind of see over here. I can't make you happy unless I am.
Got to be true to myself. 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 Day in, day out, I ask many questions. I say, only to find the truth that never changes. I say, if you don't deal with it,
and then we're going to do like three circles inside the belly. It's going to be kind of where you see like the lines in the white side of the whale. It's going to represent like the underbelly. I'm going to draw it in black. And then if you want, you can always add some white outline. That's what I did on the whale here. Kind of show it a little closer. So you can see I actually did a white outline with the black for the underbelly, just to give a little contrast and just to show the different side of the whale, make that pop out a little bit. But I'll do the black line first, just so you can kind of see where that's going. The first circle is gonna be a little shorter. The second one is gonna be the longest, and it's gonna line up right where we started again. And the third one is gonna be really small down the bottom.
I'm tired of lies and all these games. I've reached the point in life. No longer can I be this way. Don't come crying to me. I too have shed my share of tears. I'm moving on.
And I'm going to connect that circle to itself here. So it's going to end here. And then we're going to kind of have like the free floating fin at the bottom for the last fin. Whoa, Leah. I almost knocked over my whole paint station. Oh, geez, babe. It's just flying everywhere. I don't know what she's doing. I think she's trying to play. The joys of a puppy. She's crazy.
Got to be true. Got to be true. Got to be true to myself.
And I'll just go in while you guys are kind of tracing that. I will add just a little bit of white to show you what I mean. I'll just use some white paint in the paintbrush so it shows up.
Be like water, my friend. You shall find ways around or through it. When nothing within us stays rigid.
So just kind of little accent lines around the black ones. Maybe even just some little dots, however you want to do it.
Be shapeless, formless, like water. It can flow or it can grab. And we design the ways we get.
So just some white little pops, little accents. This beautiful chorus, another favorite of mine. It's called The Waves We Give. So just like water, you can decide the shape you want to go, how you want to ebb and flow. As long as we don't stay rigid, we can flow. Sometimes that's easier said than done.
Be like water, my friend.
Last two steps we're gonna do is obviously adding his other fin down here, and then we're gonna do a little eye to give him, bring him to life, give him a little character. I always feel like an eye added to any animal just kind of adds the character to him. So for the final little fin right here, we're going to do a little line where that last little circle was for your belly, and then just bring it down just like we did for this fin. It's just a little bit smaller because perspective, he's kind of facing this way. His other fin on the other side is going to be a lot smaller. So just like a line right here, so it kind of lines up with that last circle, and then bring your fin out from there. So it kind of gives him that little bottom area. So I'm going to kind of bring it in pretty close so you can see kind of how I draw it. I will be drawing it for you. You can even just do a little oval and a little white dot if that feels easy for you. I kind of do like a half of an oval for the top of the eye, almost thinking like the eyelids halfway open. And then just a little line down the bottom to show the bottom of his eye. And then I'll do a little white dot in the middle. So that's kind of always how I sketch my eyes out. So I'll do that here on the canvas. Okay, so I made it a little bigger just so you can kind of see it. Then on the other one, I'll add a little white dot for his little eyeball. Let me spell pray from your hand. Oh, the time is at hand when all things under the sky go free. The time is passing me by. I've come my time. And I'm drifting. So go back and add little dots anywhere you see fit.
Yes,
also the final step is not the eye. The final step would be your signature on your beautiful piece of art. If it doesn't feel finished to you yet, don't feel rushed like you have to sign it right away. But that is always very important to sign your artwork and your creations. I usually sign in the bottom corner, but you can put it anywhere. Some artists like to hide it or make it something where everyone tries to find it in their pieces. Very important to sign. And as we're getting close to finishing, if anyone wants to share their finished products, share them on the screen, hold them up. We'd love to see them. Don't feel pressured to do so, but if you'd like to share it, you totally can. Oh, but I just froze. My screen just froze.
I just wanna go back again.
So good.
Mother standing right next to me. Showing me what I need to see. Rain is falling into my mouth.
All right, I feel like we are already at 6 o'clock. What time is it?
6:05.
Okay, cool. I want to honor and respect everybody's time as well. I don't want to go too far over. Couple announcements. First and foremost, thank you guys for joining. This has been so fun, and I'm so grateful I get to share this space and time with all of you. Thank you for carving out the time, not only for yourself, but to join in with this community of artists and share in this. I love to see all the finished products held up. They look amazing. If you wanna tag us on Instagram or Facebook, so cool. That's amazing. Connor and Emily, so cool. These are awesome. Em, so great. Big ups to you guys. So good. I love it. Feel free to email them too. If you don't want to post or share them on social media, please don't feel like you have to. You could always email them to me. I will be sending a follow-up email with the playlist and any of the readings that I gave. Anything I share, I always try and send it to you guys so you can, you know, look into it more if you feel inclined to do so. I think that's pretty much it. Babe, any other announcements you want to share? Thank you to Marshall for his impromptu singing and cameo. We're going to pick a couple cards. Is that what we're going to do? These are from our beautiful friend, Meg Jacobino and Indy June.
So these cards have not been pre-picked. All right. Who's this right here?
That's our buddies, Connor and Emily. Big ups.
Big ups. Yo, do me a favor, little homie. With your fingers, tell me 1 through 5. Fine.
5.
So 1, 2, 3, 4.
All right, our card is I have support. So you all have support. What a beautiful thing to be reminded of.
All right, Indy. Give me a number, 1 to 5.
Look to your soul, the things that you know.
4.
4, okay.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Finding balance. Oh my goodness, are we all trying to find balance always? That is a never ending try.
Emily,
the more we do.
Give me a number, 1 to 5.
So we'll take this out.
Give me 2. All right.
3. She said 3.
She said 3?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm
right?
From
3.
My math is horrible.
I got you, girl.
1, 2.
Oh, this is awesome to end. Anything you want to find, it's out there somewhere. So whatever you want, whatever you're looking for, whatever you're aspiring to do, it's out there. You just got to go get it.
Hey, just for stoke and giggles, PJ, pick a number, 1 to 10.
1.
PJ always got to be different.
Content with what I already have. Amazing.
Look at him. He's got to speed up on the couch. Super content.
He's super content with what he has. beautiful Sunday.
Love you guys. Thanks for hanging out with us.
We love you. Thank you for spending this afternoon with us. Love you all so much. I hope you continue to create and just have fun with it. I'll be announcing the next session with my follow-up email. I don't know the date just yet because summer's upon us, but I will be doing another one, so I'll send it your way. Any suggestions or ideas of things you'd love to sketch, please send them my way. I'm always open to it. And any music you think we'd love,
shameless plug,
send them.
The 24th is our first Taco Tuesday.
It's true. At the shop, May 24th, Taco Tuesday's back. We'll be jamming 4 to 6, so Cheesy and the Crackers. We hope to see you guys there if you're local.
Las Olas.
If not, we'll be sharing live videos that you can feel like you're there with us, even if you aren't. We love you guys. Have the most special Sunday from here on out. We love you. Thank you. Thank you.
Peace.
Peace.